who's back at it, causing all that static. That's right. It's the old Fanatic. How's everyone doing? October 29th. Halloween is almost here. Two more days to Halloween, Halloween, Halloween. Two more days to Halloween, Silver Shamrock. Halloween 3, one of your boys' favorites. Now, back to the bells. Don't ask for who the bell tolls, for it tolls for thee, the New York Giants. Rest in peace. Season over. What'd the Fanatic tell you? Last. New York Jets. Rest in peace. Fanatic, go back and look. The Fanatic called it again. Rodgers. Well, I'm not going to do it. I know you're expecting it, but I'm not going to do it. Not going to do it for the Yankees just yet. But I'll be doing it. And that one I'm going to, like, appreciate more. Like, I'm going to enjoy more because I'm a Dodger fan. The football, I'm just proving that I'm right. Because I knew the Giants, I didn't have no doubts. The Jets, I had to give them the benefit of the doubt, but Rodgers, he didn't look too good in Green Bay the last year he was there. He choked. He choked before that, but he was still the MVP of the league, and he choked in the playoffs. But the last year, he just didn't look like he had it. Then he came here and got hurt. Jets, wish I had the under in their season win total. But, again, you're afraid to pull a trigger, and your old pal's not exactly rich. But I had a good weekend. Had a nice weekend. Suicide, survivor pool, whatever you want to call it. Guess who won it? This guy. Beat Goliath. Beat Coach Will. Beat the rat, all the rat. Janet. I like Janet. I mean, I like Will too, but I mean, Coach Will. Football man against this Fanatic. Janet, good friend, nice lady, good friend, but my father always said the cream rises to the top. You get a little, you know, you gotta watch it, you gotta get a little lucky. I'm not gonna lie to you folks. It's good to feel, it's a good win. Again, you guys know me by now. Yeah, the man, yeah. Then after that, the Green Bay lost my parlay. I lost to the guy that was in last. Now I think he's in eighth or seventh, whatever. He was in last, now he's not in last. And of course, I lost to him, so I'm down to third in the one league. Still in second in the one I run. And I believe I'm in second in one for the Fanatics money. But then again, I want stuff, but I don't. So last year, they even let you put the money in. So I didn't even take it. I think I had like $30 left. I think I put it's 50 or 55 or 60. I don't even know what it is. I think it's 50. I think it's 60. I think it's $59.99 to get in. Used to be $24.99. Went up every year. But the prizes are good. The merchandise is worth more money, supposedly. I mean, it's still cheap. It's still made in China, Bangladesh. But you want the merchandise, you want the officially licensed merchandise, you got to pay the price. So other than that, you know, sort of my former favorite team that used to cause me headaches, a loss. You can't lose like that. I mean, that's peewee football. Knock the ball down. And the one guy was acting like an ass, taunting the fans. Taunting the opposing players on the other team, bench to sideline. Here's a word of advice. Win the game And then you can taunt anybody you want. You can do whatever you want. Act like a jerk, ass, whatever you want to do. You lost. Jets. They stink. New England. They stink too. But on Sunday, the Jets stunk a little bit more. Last night, Pittsburgh and the Giants. Pittsburgh's a sneaky team. They got Tomlin. They got a good core. They're not. I don't think they're going to do anything, but they're always in. They're, like I said, proof is in the pudding. The guy's got a winning record, so they're going to probably get in. They'll get one of those spots, and then goodbye. I seen somebody on the internet. A Commanders fan. Where you been for the last 10, 15 years? Redskins and football team. A bandwagon jumper for Jaden Daniels. He'll get his. He'll get his. If I was coaching or playing and I had that size that I need, Daniels wouldn't have made it through that game with them sore ribs because I would bow. It's not what it used to be, man. They didn't, you know, go after the kid. They, you know, they said they stopped them. They may have settled them for four field goals. If you let up 12 points, you should win. But that's Eberflus and that offensive dummy that he got from Seattle. But what are you going to do? I mean, it was enjoyable. The college, Oregon State, broke the curse and stayed at number one. They won. Blew them out. Blew somebody out, I believe. Well, whatever, you know. Penn State and Ohio State. This is going to tell you if Penn State's for real. Because I know Ohio State has a loss, and they didn't look. They looked all right. I mean, they look a little bit shaky this week, last weekend against Wisconsin, but they still won. Excuse me. Oof. I don't know. I got to add you to. I won money and I still got odds, so figure that out. Whew. The Yankees. Daddy's calling. L.A., man. Well, you know, it's good and bad because now I'm going to have to get a couple World Series memorabilia if they win or when they win. I'm like, oh, if you can't say that. You never know. I mean, I doubt it. They looked lifeless until that two-run homer. So, I mean, and yeah, I don't like when all the Yankee fans concede or say, oh, yeah, we knew it was going to be tough. They weren't saying that last week, right before the series. Oh, we're going to get, we're going to get me. I'm not out there playing. Yeah, I'm a Dodger fan. I want them to win. But I was ready to. Because Roberts, he aggravates me. He aggravates the hell out of me. Again, I'm going to feel good if they do, when they do win. If I see you cursing yourself, you're hung by your tongue, you're a fanatic. When they win, I'm going to feel good. I'm going to get a shirt, you know, something, a hood. Who knows? I got enough hoodies. A nice t-shirt, maybe a hat. We'll see how they look, see what they always want. But probably just a shirt. I got, you know, Dodger shirt. One Dodger shirt's really, you know, work shirt, really, or a lounge shirt. And I got another nice blue one. I used to have a fake jersey, gray with the blue sleeves. I don't even know where that went. Couple hats, but I'm going to pick up something, you know, when they win. So, other than that, Halloween had a little, you know, I'm going to light up everything and show you the haunted house. That's going to be a separate video. I'm not going to spend, it's going to be like 15 minutes. So, if you're interested, you'll see it, Fanatic Haunted House. If you're interested, check it out, you know, give me compliments or say, Fanatic, you're an idiot, whatever, you know. Again, your prerogative. We're going to get back to the alphabet later. We'll get back to the alphabet on Thursday and Halloween. Or maybe next week. You know, I didn't even think about it. So, you know, things came up. I didn't give you the picks, so we'll try to give you some picks on Thursday. Saw a couple movies. We got done decorating, and we watched Cobweb. Pretty good. I mean, you know, horror movie genre, kind of weird. I mean, it kept your interest, kept your attention. The ending, men's. I mean, endings drive me nuts, but they've been driving me nuts for the last 20 years, maybe more, when the end of movie. You always got to leave a little sliver in case there's a sequel. A Cobweb, I hope there's not, but it's not like him dying, you know. It should be over, but and it probably is because it wasn't in the movie theater. So but you never know. It could be go right straight to streaming. But it's all right if you're in the mood, you know, a couple of days. I mean, even after Halloween, if you want to watch something horror. But you're in the mood tonight, tomorrow night, Halloween night. Ooh, Hallows Eve. Didn't watch The Penguin yet. I'm going to probably turn that on when we're done commiserating here. And you're laughing at my pain, but I'm really in pain right now. I'm doing all right, you know. Some windfall my way, and they were all bowing down to the man, and I'm like, yeah, okay. I didn't win the first time, dog. One person was like, oh, it figures you won. Last time I got knocked out week three. I lost a week one, bought back in, and then lost a week three. What are you talking about? Some people, you want the person that runs it or collects the money or whatever, or organizes it, don't always happen. I mean, of course it's happened. I've been down, I was out in week three a couple years ago and went all over to week 10. Oh, yeah, really? Who do you want to pick? You don't give a shit. You're out. This year, you know, it was quick. So I was like, you know, oh, who's everybody picking? You know, when I first got knocked out, I was like, ah. Then I got, who's in it? Who are you picking? And, you know, I hope he wins, hope she, whatever. And then they ended up splitting the money. They didn't want to go at it. Well, the boss didn't want to face Goliath. He was following him anyway. I don't blame him. I mean, split the money. He don't need the money anyway, you know. But he was afraid. Not this guy. Line in the sand. Cross that line, baby. Again, feels good, but it's in the rearview mirror. Fantasy, gotta get those parlays rocking. The basketball is, I mean, I'm just writing them down. I'm scouting to call it, whatever, tracking it. Ain't looked too good so far. Yeah. So, we'll keep watching, keep track. And hockey, you know, men's, I won that little parlay a couple weeks ago, week and a half ago. But then I put one in at a spur of the moment, mainly listening to the dumb Prez. But at least I'm not like Beningo, Joe Beningo, Sal Licata, BT, Mike. But Francis doesn't like the Jets, but he was all crying. Oh, yeah, Doug Rogers is broke. Fuck Rogers. Sorry. But Beningo was too much. Oh, my God. Pick another team. Please, or just watch the games, and yeah, expect to lose. I mean, I gave them the last rites. They're still mathematically in it, but when they lose Halloween night, they're gonna, you know, I know Ravens, the Texans are banged up. They don't have Diggs, and Collins is still hurt. He's not gonna play till after this game, Nico Collins, but. They'll probably still find a way to win and put that final nail in the Jets' coffin. I mean, I buried him early, but that's just fanatic. You know, that's the swagger. The Giants, I buried them in September. But now they're done. They're in last place. I mean, they're behind, the Dallas is looking very, very shaky. They're behind them. I mean, everybody was like, oh, the Commanders are going to be decent. They're in first. But again, the Bears gave them the game. They stopped them. They made them settle for the field goals, and then they finally started clicking. Ah, Caleb's another one. I don't know. Pump the brakes on him. But they still could have won. That shows heart and grit, you know. Stick to it. Your defense keeps you in it. You get a chance to win. But then your defense let you down with the stupid not batting it down. But again, and they didn't rush the guy. They should have had one more guy rushing. You don't need a spy. He ain't going to make it all the way to the end zone. Come on. Once those guys see him break and he's got to be past the line of scrimmage. You don't think Jalen Johnson or Edwards is going to tackle him? TJ Edmonds. Edwards made a terrible play. I turned it off when it was 12-0. I had three games going and I put that one off. I didn't want to see it. I mean, again, I still want them to win. I still got the memorabilia. I got everybody keep sending, buying me shit. I still got tons of stuff. Some of the stuff I did throw out that was ratty or just mad and burned it. But that's done. This stuff's just going to stay in the closet. I got the Urlacher jersey, which, of course, I love because that's my guy. He's gone, but that's tradition. I got the Khalil Mack jersey that I wore like once or twice. I want to sell it. Probably going to sell it. I do have a 2XL Bears shirt that I got on accident. Somebody sent me, and no question, I go, hey, give me the receipt. Say thank you. Get rid of that one. So I got a couple things I want to get rid of that's not. I mean, it's got the tags on it. If it was like, I wore it, throw it in garbage. You know, it is what it is. Again, those guys are too much. They're crying and crying and crying. But oh, they were the greatest thing going in September or end of August. Oh, the Jets. Relax, New York. Just down and then after the Yankees finally admit defeat and go down in defeat, they're gonna switch to the Knicks. Or the Rangers. Or the Islanders. Who knows? I don't know if the Islander fans even say anything except for Evan. But we'll see. I mean, they ain't going to go nowhere. Devils. Devils are quiet, even though they're from New Jersey. People, you know. Celebrities like yappers don't seem to follow the Devils. But we'll see. I mean, to be honest with you, they got the New York does have one thing. They have the Buffalo Bills. But that's far away, so they don't like the Bills. And the Bills, again, Bills have talent. They're gonna win the East. Just like I said in the video, go back and look. AFC predictions. I just saw that the other day and clicked on it. I was laughing at myself, so you'll probably laugh. But the predictions are right. There's a couple of little jokes in there, you know, a couple of digs or whatever you want to call them. I think you'll enjoy it. So rewatch that one and see how the picks went. Proof is in the pudding. They're going to win the division. I don't know. Then after that, all depends on how Allen, if he doesn't play hero ball and does the right thing. And the defense is getting a little bit better. They're going to get Von Miller back if he wants to play or if he really just wants the money. He's already won the Super Bowl already, whatever. Or if he might not have anything left. I mean, when he was playing before he got suspended for acting like an ass or whatever he did, threatening harassment or a domestic thing, whatever the heck happened with that dummy. I didn't hear him calling his name. I didn't see him do nothing. We'll see. I mean, he was home, so who knows? Maybe he was a little banged up. He's always banged up. But when you see the guy, he looks like a gorilla. He was a body of a foe. God, what a physique on him. And when he was in his prime, he was an animal. He was all over the place. He was in the backfield. He was in the backfield more than the running backs most of the time. But we'll see what he's got left. Again, they don't care about the Bills. I wanted to give you one more. We saw another movie. An old one. Oh, God. See, now, you know, that's what happens. Jeepers Creepers. And they went too far with that one, of course. But the original one is enjoyable. I like that kid. I like that kid, Dari. And I like that girl. You know, I wonder if she's in anything else. Because I thought she was pretty good. And she's, you know, she's attractive. I mean, I don't know. You know, she's attractive in a brunette kind of way. I'm not. She looks, you know. And she, I thought she was a good actress, too. So, you know, I don't know. Maybe he did something. I know that the kid did something else, but I don't remember off the top of my head what. But Jeepers Creepers, check that one out. Oh, all right. Nothing else is really coming out of my senses. You know, you see the creepy crew, the Pops, or the Universal Monsters. No mummy, though. This Frankenstein, Dracula, the Creature from the Black Lagoon, and the Wolfman. A lot of people don't really remember or know the Creatures from the Black Lagoon. I mean, it must be a dying thing. I mean, everybody knows about the mummy because of the mummy, Brandon Fraser, and then they tried Tom Cruise. And it says, hey, there's a mummy, you know, bandage. But he didn't make the shirt. The Creature from the Black Lagoon took his spot. No Bride of Frankenstein, but it is what it is. Again, you heard it a million times. All right, I'm going to wrap this up, and it's going to be hot on hot weather, nice weather for the trick-or-treaters, so you better go get some more candy if you got kids coming, because it's going to be nice out. Give the kids some candy. Cheapo, spend a little cash. Don't send them here though. Shades, lights off. Shades, Fanatic. I'm gonna leave you with this. Laugh and the world laughs with you. Cry and you cry alone. And as always, please always remember. And never forget opinions, except for this guy's, are like Fanatic. On the lookout for early trick-or-treaters and Goosey Niners. Back to my coffin. Peace. See you tomorrow. Show you around at Halloween. The Fanatic's Haunted House. Peace.